So before we get started, I'd like to point out that if your coordinates are in latitude and longitude, then I have a full video which explains how to convert latitude and longitude into UTM by using GIS. So if your coordinates are in latitude and longitude, please go and watch that video. I'll make sure that I put that video in the description below. Okay, so if your coordinates are in UTM format, let's get started. We're going to discuss how to find distance between two coordinates when you have coordinates, let's say in eastings and northings. So you have two coordinates, or if you have a series of multiple coordinates and you need to know the distance that was covered by those points. Okay, so let's say an example, you have a pipe, or you have coordinates that was taken on a pipe and you need to know the total distance that was covered by that pipe. And again, if you have points that was taken in a road or in highway or in a road, and you need to know the distance, the total distance covered by that road. So it's simple. Again, we are going to use a very simple formula. And again, I think it's better to go and have a little theory behind this formula. So we are going to start. Let's say you have two points, and your first point is this one, A. Your first point is A, and the second one is B, and you really need to know the distance between them. And point A has x1 and y1, okay? And point 2, the same, x2, y2, and okay, and you need to know the distance between these two points. Again, the formula is the same. If you remember coordinate geometry, this it is exactly the same. So you know that the distance is square root of these two points, right? X1, x2, y2, y1, minus them, you square them, you get the distance. Again, for our case, the distance here will the distance will be square root not just of x and y's, it will be the square root of difference between the coordinates between eastings and northings, right? Between eastings and northings. We are not just going to find distance, we even go further and find the chainage, especially when you have multiple points. Okay, when you have multiple points, you really need to, if you want to know the distance between them or the distance covered by those points, you need to really go and find chainage. Again, I'm going to show you step by step, and surely it will be very easy. And again, we are going to use Microsoft Excel for this exercise. And that being said, let's go straight to Microsoft Excel. So here we have two points, point A and point B. Again, we need to know the distance between them. Okay, so the first point we'll call it as 0. That is our starting point. And the second point here is B. So B, we need to know the distance from B to A. Okay. B to A. So the formula here is square root, as I said earlier, is square root sqrt. So we need to know x1, no, x2 is this minus x1, that one. So square plus x, then you minus, okay, square. And you take a square of it. Remember, one thing you need to remember is that this is x2, this one is x1, y2, y1. Okay, y2, y1. So if you press enter, you get the distance here, which is 1.569. Okay, this is in meter. This is in meter because eastings and northings are literally measured in meter. In meter. So the distance between point A and point B is 1.69. So this is the case when you have only two points. But what if you have a series of points? What if you have multiple points that was taken along a road or along a pipeline, or in any situation that you need to know a linear distance between point A and B, and between point A and B you have multiple coordinates that was taken. So we are going to copy this formula here. We are going to another sheet. So you just, let's start with 0 and just paste here formula. Just paste formula here. Go and put, you see this cross there, just double click it, just double click. So what it does is that it goes and find distance between these points, between this and this, between this and this. Okay, and it goes like that. Between, but one thing you need to know is that the first point is the origin. Just put it zero. Again, if you need to know the distance, the total distance here, of course you can do manual, you can plus them manually, but for this case we're going to use chainage formula, which is, again, as we know that chainage is nothing but summation of distance, or cumulative distance is what we call it as chainage. Okay, chainage. So d1 plus d2 plus d3 all the way to dn. For our case, we're going to take d1, again it will be this plus this, okay, this plus this. Again, you do the same, you can even drop it. So as you can see here, is that is how we find the distance between two coordinates. And so that being said, thank you, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one.